This is 109. So it's just these rooms, just this hallway. 110 and 111 are not your patients. So,
any questions?
Okay, is that all right? Okay, then get to work.
For a few moments, it seemed too close to call. The Vatican seemed to be giving mixed signals, smoke signals, that is.
But as the bells tolled, it was loud and clear. The smoke was white, and the Catholic Church.
It's an emergency.
Pope Joseph Cardinal Ratzinger.
I already ate.
Is now Pope Benedict the 16th.
I'm sorry.
We'll on him in a moment.
First to St. Peter's Square. It's quiet and dark there right now, but early.
I saved an old woman.
And excitement as
the chickens in the oven.
Mission turned into reality TV. The ringing went on for 10 minutes, sending thousands running to the square as the rain started to fall.
That's not chocolate, is it? You're not eating chocolate, are you?
I just wanted to celebrate.
Where are you at? You know that you're fat, don't you?
More cheers as Cardinal Joseph Ratzinger of Germany was announced as Pope Benedict XVI. The crest of Pope John Paul II was unfurled in his honor. Then Pope Benedict emerged, addressed the crowd, and offered a blessing.
Have elected me,
a
simple, humble worker in God's vineyard.
You're not going to get fired again, are you?
I saved an old woman today.
I like Chicago. I don't like New York. I want to go back. Sylvia.
Good morning, Mary.
I called Chicago yesterday. Geriatric department. Seems you were fired there. You never told us.
They didn't allow me to do my job.
Well, it seems that some of your patients...
I'm a good nurse.
Why didn't you answer my question yesterday?
What?
Why did you enter that room? That wasn't your patient.
I just thought...
But she wasn't your patient.
I heard someone calling for help. I wanted to be sure that...
She was okay 10 minutes before you entered the room, and she wasn't calling for help. I was right there.
She was dying!
She's dead. Embolism. Silvia? Where are you going? Silvia, come back here. There are a lot of questions you need to answer. The manager wants to speak with you, Silvia. Silvia!
Cheese to the nth degree, you know, something.
I need to take a shower, Mom!
Residents talk about apartment 3C in this building in Inwood. They say a man who'd lived alone died here the last week of January. Cops had to remove his body 3 weeks later.
Why are you here now?
Relatives came forward, but nobody's since cleaned up after the remains the rotting corpse left behind. And that was 2 months ago.
We cannot leave, we cannot leave, we cannot do anything for the town.
She, her three children, and mother.
What is this?
The apartment. She opened this closet.
I'm sorry, Mom. Why are you not at work? Oh my God, what are you doing? Yeah. Sorry.
The next door neighbor,
I knew you would get fired again.
He's put tape around his door to try to keep out the
I'm a good nurse. Sylvia.
Crazy.
Residents in this building that has lots of children called 311 over
Sylvia!
And over.
Sylvia, come out now! I need to take a shower, Mom, please! What? Why aren't you at work?
Right.
Sylvia!
Smells intensify.
Sylvia, come out now!
Sylvia, what are you doing in there?
I'm James Ford.
It was apparently someone's idea of a joke on the anniversary of the Oklahoma City bombing.
Sylvia, what are you doing in there? Sylvia! Sylvia, come out! Sylvia! Sylvia! Sylvia, come out immediately! Sylvia! Sylvia, come out immediately!
Pope Benedict XVI, Joseph Ratzinger's ferocious devotion to church doctrine earned him the nickname God's Rottweiler. He served for over 20 years as chief theological advisor to Pope John Paul II, and the two were close friends. Personally, he's regarded as humble and charming, a conservative intellectual. But in matters of doctrine, he is known as Cardinal No. No to ordained women, no to married priests, no to homosexuality, no to rock music. Cardinal Ratzinger is the first German pope in almost a millennium. He turned 78 years old on Saturday. He has no history of chronic health problems, but we have learned he's been hospitalized twice since the early 90s, one after another.